The North against the South. It's coming your way next on Fox Sports Net.
It's College Football Rivalry Week, where team records and rankings don't mean diddly. In Oregon, the Ducks and the Beavers will battle it out in the 102nd version of the Civil War. Akili Smith and the 15th-ranked Ducks are marching toward the school's best season in history. A victory over their furry little interstate rivals would be their fifth consecutive in this century-old series. But these Beavers aren't a bunch of tree huggers. Oregon State has a chance to post its best record since 1971. To accomplish that feat, they'll have to shoot down the Ducks. Dig into your bunkers, boys. It's time for the Civil War.
And hi, everybody. I'm Steve Fizziak. This is Tom Ramsey. In the Pacific Northwest, they simply call it the Civil War. They're separated by only 40 miles, but they involve just about every single family in the state. And there's even more significance, it seems, this year, Tom.
Well, it means a lot for both teams. Of course, Mike Bellotti with the Oregon Ducks, they most assured themselves of a bowl game this year, but they also have a chance at a 10-win season, the first time ever. And, of course, Mike Riley guiding the Oregon State Beaver program back to somewhat prominence. They may have a 5-win season for the first time since 1971. I think Akili Smith right now, Steve, is playing with extreme confidence, and he has a great surrounding troop of offensive individuals around him. He leads the Pac-10 in passing yards and TDs, and you got to remember, he's second in the nation in passing efficiency as well.
Oregon needs to win to go to a major bowl. For Oregon State, this really is their bowl game. And now the number 15 team in the nation, the University of Oregon. How is the field after 3 inches of rain the last 2 days?
Well, surprisingly, Steve, the field conditions actually are quite good, this being the oldest turf in the entire Pac-10 at 14 years of age. And we already talked about the fact it's going to be ripped out outside the hash marks. It's in tough shape. But in this very special game, given the weather conditions that we anticipate later today, special teams may well decide who wins the Civil War. A Grozo Award finalist, marking the best kicker in the entire country in Nathan Viegas, started the year making 14 straight field goals. He's 18 of 20 on the year, but does not quite have the leg strength of Jose Cortez, who is absolutely spectacular. He's made a 55-yarder. But I'll tell you, Steve, about an hour ago when both kickers were out here warming up in a stiff breeze, neither of them could have thrown the ball through the upright. So if the weather stays good, the kickers are going to be a big
fan. Oregon, they won the toss, and they have elected to receive, so Jose Cortez will kick off. What is interesting about Oregon winning the toss is that they have received every single football game this year. And here is the kickoff by Cortez. He has an excellent leg, and he brings it to the 5-yard line. Out comes Michael Fletcher. He is past the 25, and Fletcher with a fine run back, 6'3", 215, a senior from San Diego, California. He's thrown for almost 3,000 yards and 26 touchdowns. Michael Clues has a big responsibility. How will he play? Anoki Brechterfield, the great defensive end for the Beavers. And Herman Hoching is a running back playing with a slight problem in his right knee, but he is an outstanding true freshman from Long Beach Poly High School in Southern California. Smith will throw on the first play of the game. It is incomplete, but he needs a great rush from the front line. Anoki Brechterfield is 5'10½", 249 pounds, but man, can he fly. The linebackers, Brian Jones runs a 4-4 in the 40, and he goes 6'4", 217. And there's Andre Holland, number 23, the great cornerback. He was burnt 2 weeks ago on the play by Brad Melsby that won the game for UCLA, even though he had a wonderful game. And Smith is sacked back at the 22-yard line by Brian Jones.
Oregon electing to max protect, which they do a lot for Akili Smith. They just want to turn, protect, and really keep their eye on Brechterfield. But right there, Brian Jones using his speed off the edge and making the hit.
He did not. The result is 3rd and 19. With plenty of time, throws, and the pass is broken up. Now Josh Bidwell has a monster leg, averaging 45 plus per punt this year, but he's punting it to a dangerous return man in Tim Alexander, the former quarterback. Was a quarterback in the Civil War game last year. Alexander, for a chance to return, returns a 10 to the 30. The offensive line is led by Larry Ramirez, a 4-year starter. He has never beaten Oregon. Running backs and wide receiver watch for Greg Ainsworth against their nickel package. Ainsworth will be in the slot a lot. And yes, Oregon has two talented cornerbacks, but their nickel defensive back may not be able to match up with Ainsworth. The flag goes down in the very first run by Oregon State.
5 yards to the previous spot. Still first down.
How much emotion does this team have left?
Boy, I think they were helped out by the fact that they had a bye week coming into this game against Oregon. They did have time to regroup and really realize they could have a good season with a win.
This is Simonton slashing forward for about 4 yards. And the defense for Oregon, it is a very good one. Saul Patu has 4 sacks this year. He's their best pass rusher. The linebackers are very, very quick. Chris Vandeveer has 77 tackles. He had 19 in one game against Stanford. And then the secondary, Brandon McLemore, whose brother, Christian, was an all-conference wide receiver at Oregon. Brandon goes the free safety, and he's a big one at 6'2", 215. Second and one. In motion, Ainsworth. There. Wow, Oregon's defense led by Leia Sualua. And they lost their best down lineman in Desmond Bird. Also lost their best linebacker this year in Peter Sermon. Ken Simonton won't get back to the line of scrimmage. It will be second down and 11. Anthony Martin, the senior from San Jose, start tonight because it is the final regular season game. So Martin makes a start over Miller.
Well, I tell you how important it is for those defensive linemen to get in and really they're able to shed the blocker at the line of scrimmage, make the play.
They show a four-man rush, and that's what they'll send. And they hand the ball up to Jason Dandridge, who had a wonderful game against UCLA last week with 130 yards. So Smith on 3rd and 9. The pass is complete right at midfield. The mark will be really important by the official.
And you know what? That's a costly mistake. Mike Riley trying to teach his guys the little things. And if you're going to run a hook route, as James Battle did, run the hook route far enough for the first down.
That's the exact question you asked Mike Riley yesterday. He said, well, not early, but here he goes. 4th down and inches. They run the fullback for the first down.
I really believe, these sorts of plays, you talk about the emotion of the game a few moments ago, Steve, a big 4th down in the first quarter right here. They elect to go for it right at midfield.
And this is typical of a rivalry game. This is Simonton, big hole, and he is slashing to the 38-yard line.
Well, you wonder why it's a big hole sometimes. You're going to see Aegis Hogtie, Aaron Cook, end up just threw his man to the ground. He got caught for the holding.
Offense, 10 yards, spot of the foul. Still first down.
Jonathan Smith, he's throwing long. Alexander's there. Great catch at the 29-yard line.
Well, this is what Jonathan Smith gives this offense, some potency and plays down the field. The ball does not come out of his hand real good right here. Ball kind of wobbles on him a little bit, but credit Tim Alexander. He ends up adjusting his route, coming down and making a great play. Watch as he comes underneath, just really almost the post route, and he comes back for the football. A great job, and of course, he had 10 catches 2 weeks ago versus UCLA.
They say he is just getting better and better every single game. This is coming offside. This is Simonton trying to bust outside. He will get to the 22-yard line. I do not see a flag down. But we are in Corvallis, Oregon at Parker Stadium. Kansas State was winning their football game against the University of Missouri in Columbia. And here's Simonton again struggling for, he's very close to the first down. Needed to get just inside the 19-yard line for a first down. So they give it to Ken this time, and the Oregon defense is wrapping him up. Leia.
Boy, again, the line of scrimmage. Who controls it? That's the name of the game right there. And Sualua comes down the line of scrimmage, puts the hit on the ball carrier. And Oregon State right here electing to go with Jose Cortez.
Cortez with the great leg into the wind, but it rushes off to the left side. A team that leads the conference in scoring at 41 points per game. A lot of fans, you can tell, at the green and gold in the stands have traveled for 40 miles from Eugene. And here they are, watching their offense, led by superstar Keeley Smith. Hand off to Ho Ching, and he gets nothing. He will lose about 5 yards in the play. Tell Kevin Frazier that there is absolutely no emotion in the press box because Tom Ramsey is a Pac-10 guy. He is no longer a Bruin.
Achille has really been in fuego. He has been on fire. And, you know, the Oregon offense knows that. They're right. I talked to the coaches, and they said, hey, the guy is playing so good, and we're so happy. They want to just let him play and keep the ball in his hands.
Smith throws, completes the pass, first down, 37-yard line.
Well, and Ruben Drones counted for so much of that yardage. But right here, who does he hook up with? Donald Haynes, his old teammate at Grossmont College. Right there, they both transferred into Oregon together, and Donald Haynes, a good receiver.
Bobby Nero is in the game, and they'll run the football. Not much there. Oregon State has done a nice job defending the run. It was Anoki Brechterfield. He would be 11-1 and be very deserving. Here is Akili Smith. He will throw the pass, trying to just throw it away. He throws it to his tight end, Jed Weaver, for a short
Oregon,
game.
Oregon, you know, they're number three and third down conversion. They're right in the race for that Pac-10.
Smith backing up. Now the protection arose. He's scrambling to his right and will not escape the great Brian Jones. His second sack of this game.
I think when you run that well at this level, it just really pays dividends for you. Right there, you see Akili Smith, who's pretty quick himself. He slipped a little bit on that turf. And
you have to watch these Oregon State special teams. They're very good at blocking punts. Bidwell does get it off and hangs it in the air to Tim Alexander. He has a chance for the turn. They've got a wall set up to the right, but Alexander went to the middle. Gets it back to the 29. We are scoreless, 3:48 remaining. Let's go back to 1962. Oregon State and Heisman Trophy winner Terry Baker. He would hit Dan Espalin on 4th and 7 with 11 minutes and 24 seconds to play from 12 yards out, and Oregon State went on to win 20-17. The coach was Tommy Prothro. They would go to the Liberty Bowl that year and lose to Villanova 6-0, led by Terry Baker.
Well, was Terry Baker sweet or what? See that ball come out? Just perfect right over the defender. Touchdown. Those were the days up here.
And now Jonathan Smith going deep, but his man fell down, Tim Alexander. Jonathan Smith from Glendora, California. Starting quarterback 3 years in high school, but had to walk on in the Pac-10. And here is a redshirt freshman. He is playing. Well, he does have a nice release, but it is tipped and almost picked off by Dietrich Moore, who intercepted one last week and took it back 78 yards for a touchdown against Arizona. So Smith's got to know that those linebackers may be blitzing here. They're showing blitz from the right side. No, they just rushed four. Smith, incomplete. It was intended for James Battle. Flags all over the place.
Yeah, I think they might have flagged Brandon McLemore out of Bishop Montgomery High down in Torrance. And Oregon does such a great job on nickel coverage. Right there, they go in and out, really, on James Battle. They have a cone coverage.
Pass interference on the defense, 15 yards from previous spot. Automatic first down.
Great wide receiver in Pat Johnson. Both had phenomenal games in the victory over Oregon State. Well, the Beavers do try and run the football. Gain just 1 yard. It'll be second down and 9.
Oregon before the game, and I just asked him about Saladin McCullough. He didn't make a roster in the NFL, but he's back in school up at Oregon. But he said Herman Ho-Ching runs a little bit like McCullough, has that same forward lean. And anyone has watched Oregon football the last couple of years, boy, Saladin McCullough was one of the best.
They got another great one this year, Ruben Drones, but he broke his leg against UCLA. He is gone for the year. So another short run by Oregon State, and that's one thing Mike Riley said. We are determined to get a running game going. We have to hammer the middle. We've got to get to the edges, or if we try and throw 60 times, we'll lose. 3rd and 7, trips to the left. Smith throws it to Alexander. First down, but there is a flag down. And I'm wondering if there's an illegal pick on that far side. That's the play.
Offside. Defense. Penalties refused.
That Nick Eliotti, who is the defensive coordinator at UCLA, calls the communist play. Why, Tom?
Well, you can complete the ball behind the line of scrimmage. It's only allowed in college and right here. It's not allowed in the pro ranks. But as long as the ball is completed behind the line of scrimmage, you can release blockers down the field. And that's why defensive coordinators just have sleepless nights.
I think that's a speed option, don't you?
In a way.
2 to the right, 1 to the left. Smith on first down. They run Simonton. He breaks one tackle, breaks another, has the first down. Look at this kid go! King Simonton to the 4-yard line.
And Kenny Simonton wants it. He gets after it. Not only they catch Oregon in a blitz right here, Chevron misses him in the backfield. Watch how he hits and twists. Boom, Fletcher hits him. He's off. Fletcher Bowman comes up. He misses Bowman. All of a sudden, he's going to drop a shoulder and try to run over Eric Edwards, but he gets inside the 5-yard line. Big pickup for Kenny Simonton.
He needs only 75 more for 1,000. Would be one of only four Beavers ever to go over 1,000 yards. And Oregon State history. Now first and goal, 4-yard line. They have the heavy load hook, double tight end. They will run the football and slashing to the 2-yard line. They go back to Simonton. He drives to about the 1.5-yard line. There is a flag down, though.
Dead ball, personal foul, offense. 15 yards from the end of the run. The third down.
Check out the total yards. Only 4 for Oregon so far today.
Second down. Now it's third down, excuse me. We have a timeout on the field. We'll come right back with 36 seconds remaining in the first quarter.
No one knows if the mind rules the body or the body rules the mind. The University of Oregon encourages both. In addition to 18 Rhodes Scholars, 203 Fulbright Scholars, and 2 Nobel Prize winners, 10 of our 78 Olympic competitors won medals in their events. So whether the mind or the body is more important just depends on what circles you run in.
Oregon mascot has that defense fired up. A nothing-nothing ball game with 36 seconds remaining. Third down, 17 yards to go. Third and goal, really, from the 17 for Jonathan Smith. He will go to the air. Oregon is blitzing. Smith downfield. Incomplete. He was looking for Martin Maurer, his tight end.
Tell you, when he hits the ball, though, that ball just comes rocketing off his foot. He may have a career in the pros just because of his distance.
From 34 yards out, Oregon State has the lead. This is the 102nd game, the longest rivalry on the West Coast. Oregon and Oregon State. The Ducks lead the series 51 wins to 40. There have been 10 ties. Right now, Oregon State opening over the 3-0 lead. And here comes Michael Fletcher, and he's met, and he breaks one tackle, and he goes down at the 18-yard line.
Check out Michael Fletcher. He breaks between two defenders, and then, wham! Hello. Man, you can feel that.
Oregon State with 8 men on that front line. Keely Smith wants to run it, and not much there again as Herman Ho Ching gains maybe 2 yards to the 21 or 22.
But time out. We have a quarter.
Oregon State has 2 drives over 50 yards, but they have scored only 3 points. That's the bad news. Oregon has 4 total yards. This is a team that is first in the Pac-10 Conference in scoring and total offense, and Oregon State has shut them out. That's exactly what Mike Riley wanted to do. He said the team had success. They started believing themselves 2 weeks ago because they shut out UCLA after the first quarter. And Damon Griffin cannot hold on as Andre Holland breaks up the play. It's like Craig Newhouse, the defensive coordinator, says. Apparently his Beavers have gotten their eyes right. They're reading the plays well. Here is Smith going back to Griffin. This time he makes the catch, breaks the tackle, and gets the first down to the 30-yard line. Damon Griffin.
They're going to just max protect this. The back's going to come over and block, and really, it's just a 2-man route. It allows Akili Smith that added time against this Oregon State pressure. They turn, protect, everyone stays in, 2-man route. He fires the ball out to Damon Griffin. I'll tell you, you're taking chances there sometimes because I think offensive philosophy, as many guys as you can get into the route as possible, is what's going to help you out.
Here is Herman Ho Ching, not much there. He is cut down at the 31, 32-yard line.
You have to always account for Inoki Brechter Field. They just have to make a point of always finding him. Right there, you see Ho Ching, really nothing on the interior. They're going to try to run a couple different plays with him today, what's really called a fan or a more or less taking a look at the Beaver linebackers. Jackson right there, really the playmaker, leading tackler, second leading tackler in the Pac-10 alone.
second and eight. They try and throw that inside screen to Damon Griffin. This time the Beavers are all over it, but there is a flag that goes down.
Flipping offense, 15 yards, follow the foul. Still second down.
And I think that the Oregon State coaches feel good about the fact that other coaches in the Pac-10, most notably Bob Toledo, Mike Filani, Dick Toney, very respected coaches, say such nice things and glowing things about their defensive personnel.
But Mike said, it's time to win now. Here's Smith, all kinds of time downfield. First down, Damon Griffin, 44-yard line.
You know, one of the things Oregon State defensive coaches were worried about were these big angles. And watch these big angles take place. A great shot right there. You see both wideouts, Hartley and Griffin, coming across. And Damon Griffin, I tell you, he is a great player.
Smith back to the air. He is a big play quarterback and puts it back to Griffin. Very close to a first down.
Now Florida State. Now Florida dropped down. You know, Arizona moves up again with a bye week, probably. I think Florida will probably drop below them. Florida now has two losses. They also lost to Tennessee, remember, earlier in the year. Well, it's going to be interesting. Someone might be a little upset come December 6th. That's my guess.
No question. Playoffs still are really not done correctly. Play tight end at UC Davis, then coached at Chico State. After the illegal procedure, that will make it second down and 6 yards to go. Oregon averages almost 7 yards per play, the best in the Pac-10 Conference. They need seven for a first down. Smith flipping it. Oh, that was dangerous. This time, Griffin will go wide left. And Tony Hartley, who has not caught a pass, goes to the right side. Third and six. Oop. Someone was in the neutral zone. It may have been Rectorfield.
Snap. There was contact by the defense. That's a 5-yard penalty. It'll still be third down.
Smith will run the football. Not much there, and Oregon State has done it again.
And that isn't the Mike Filani offense right there. That is not a picture of efficiency. Oregon just getting stuffed at the line of scrimmage, and you see Brechterfield right there in the middle, number 56.
Now Bidwell. And he hammers it. Alexander calls for the fair catch right at the 20-yard line. Oregon State has the lead, 3-0, 11 minutes remaining in the first half. We go back 31 years to 1967 in the first game played at Autzen Stadium. Oregon State rallied in the fourth quarter to win on a 5-yard run by Steve Priest to win it 14-10. And Steve Priest now calling action on Fox Sports Northwest. On their tape delay game, he's in the booth just opposite us. There's a throw to the sideline, and Tim Alexander, and Alexander very close to a first down. And Jonathan Smith, let's see, they've got an option, second down and only one. Ainsworth will go in motion, and they will throw. And it is broken up. Someone got their hand on it. Now they'll go with that double tight end look. A wing to the right side, third and one. That defensive tackle came through so quickly. Aia Suolaila told us that he will try and punt the football where Fletcher has to run to get it. And they do try and do that, and boy, he hits this one well. Inside the 20, inside the 10. Will they save it? No! This is the day of rivalries in college football. Already today, we saw Yale beat Harvard 9-7. Ohio State beat Michigan. UCLA beat USC. Stanford over Cal. Washington over Washington State. And here it is Oregon State leading Oregon 3-0. Akili Smith going downfield to his tight end, who gets the first down. Jed Weaver. Four guys, including the tight end, that average over 19 yards per catch. That's remarkable.
Boy, again, little play action into the line. They just zone protect up front. They do a great job giving Smith time to throw. And then he just fires a bullet.
Weaver, a senior from Redmond, Oregon. Smith will go with one running back, three wide out. He goes to Ho-Ching, and Herman tries the middle, gains three to the 49-yard line.
Ho-Ching, of course, he had 117 alone versus Texas El Paso. But the workload really falls on the shoulders of Akili Smith for this offense.
So Smith goes sideline again. He's beginning to heat up.
Have someone try and carry the load for them and just take a little heat off Akili Smith.
Third, and then Smith takes a knee, and he points right at the defense that was in the neutral zone.
Before the snap, there was contact by the defense. That's a 5-yard penalty. First down.
Again, credit to Keely Smith.
Yeah, you're right. Weaver left after the ball was snapped. Akili looking downfield. Man open. Damon Griffin inside the 10-yard line.
Keely Smith, he is on fire. He just throws a great ball this time to Damon Griffin right down the heart of the center of the field. You're going to see Griffin. He just runs a post. And tell you, once again, Akili Smith gets great time, and they're going to find a hole right in the middle of that defense. Actually, David Griffin came from the outside. My bad that time. They just ran a deep crossing route. And Griffin down the middle of the field and catches the bullet fired by Akili.
First and goal from the 7 again. Oregon can't run.
Now take a look again. There's Breckerfield won't go down ever on that first block. Weaver tried to come down on him. And
second and goal. Smith goes back to the air. Downfield. Touchdown. Tony Hartley.
For four touchdowns in the first half alone. Right here, a little play action. He has two receivers coming across the field. Again, just right on target to Tony Hartley with his 9th touchdown of the year. He came in averaging over 21 yards a catch as well.
So Tony Hartley on the 100th catch of his career. Well, here is Ainsworth, and Ainsworth on the return gets it out to about the 35-yard line. Oregon State down by 4 points. 100th career catch by Tony Hartley is a 9-yard touchdown. The interesting thing about that, he has 9 touchdown catches this year. The all-time record for Oregon is the great Bobby Moore, who, of course, is the sportscaster Ahmad Rashad. He had 10 in one season, so Hartley with one more. I mean, they count bowl games, so he's got a great chance to break the record. That foul is dropped.
Fourth in the Pac-10s. I mean, they're going to get him the ball quite a bit. He has 55 receptions coming into the game today.
On second and 10, Smith in trouble. Blitz is on. Here comes Bowman. Smith going deep, incomplete.
Yeah, receiver spread out all over the field.
Flips it to the right. Alexander's pass is too tall. Here's Fessler. End over end this time. A chance for a fine Fletcher return. And he's got a big hole. And Mike goes all the way to midfield. But a flag will go down.
From Paramount High down in Compton, Southern California.
Well, this guy's
fielding
got some great speed.
By the receiving team during the run back. That's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
Offenses benefit so much by having the ball close to midfield. This time, of course, a penalty against Oregon.
Herman Ho-Ching, they have defended the run so well. Anoki Brechterfield stretching it out.
You learn to hate them when you're a Beaver, and I pretty much learned to do that, you know. But I have a few friends on the team, but you know, when you're on the field, it's war, and that's the way I approach it.
And here's a guy, 5'10 and a half, 245 pounds, and might be the defensive player of the year in the Pac-10 conference if he had played on a bigger school. And here he comes again with the sack of Akili Smith.
And he said he's just happy when people mention his name as a great player. Watch him. Ho-Ching, the running back, just whips on the block and misses.
Mike Singletary wasn't a big guy, and he was a great linebacker with the Bears. Smith in trouble again, trying to find Tony Hartley. It will be 3 and out for the Oregon Ducks. So dangerous. Bidwell hammers it. Boy, he sends it far. Alexander from the 20. Alexander's got the sideline. Flag goes down. There may be a clip. Alexander is gone. And he's cut down by Bidwell, but it's coming back.
Credit once again. Tim Alexander just does a great job of
right there
picking up some blocks. Oh,
right there.
Yeah, not sure who that was, but sure enough, they came and hit him high.
Holding by the receiving team during the run back. That's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
three receivers to the left. Smith will run the football. It is Simonton, and he has drilled after a three-yard gain. Second down, 7 yards to go for the Beavers. Smith will dump it out to Prescott, and Robert Prescott is up near the 25-yard line, but not much room. And Smith, moving up to the line of scrimmage, will take a timeout. And here comes Jonathan Smith. They'll have two wide receivers to the left. One is in the slot. That is Greg Ainsworth. Now he will go in motion, and McLemore will have to take that. They will blitz Jonathan Smith. The pass is thrown to Ainsworth. Look at this. Greg Ainsworth's gone.
Good use of a timeout. Jonathan Smith didn't like what he saw, and all of a sudden he's able to drop back, set his feet quick as Oregon is in the blitz. They catch him in the blitz. He's able to outrun number 9. Brandon McLemore, the free safety, you're right, had a little bit of a mismatch.
And Oregon State has reclaimed the lead in Corvallis. All of a sudden the defensive coaches are talking with him. Where were you? Third and three. Fletcher breaks a tackle, and Michael tries to break a couple more. He gets it out to the 28-yard line and earns him the hard way.
Well, it's interesting. You know, they like Ainsworth in the slot, but watch as Ainsworth comes across here. They're going to bring blitz, and what Ainsworth does, all of a sudden, he's man-on-man with McLemore, but anytime quarterbacks and receivers feel or see blitz, all of a sudden you're taught, cut your route short, turn your head and be looking for the ball, because the ball is coming out anytime it's blitz right there. Oregon State doing a great job.
Here's Akili Smith backing up. He's looking to the sideline, and Damon Griffin has to go to his knees to pick it off. Did he make the catch? Yes, he did. Enough for a first down. Smith has half of them in the last three-plus games.
Yeah, Smith has done a great job. Both Smiths, Akili and Jonathan, but march it down and get Oregon some points.
Damon Griffin with the catch, the first down, and Akili Smith had two rushers right in his face as he was delivering that pass. Herman Hoching trying to break outside. And he will only gain about 2-3 yards.
Well, very much so. I mean, they want to be close at the half, and then they know emotion. Mike Riley knows emotion's going to carry him through in the second half.
Akili Smith's going for the bomb. Damon Griffin's out there. It is almost picked off by Andre Holland. Holland was the kid who was beaten 2 weeks ago on that long pass to Brad Melsby that resulted in a 61-yard touchdown, the play that won the game. Holland really played a marvelous game and has started very well in this contest.
Yeah, he really has. And, you know, he's close. He has great position this time and makes the play on the ball. Hey, he even makes a good play. It's Damon Griffin stripping him of the ball so he doesn't make the pick.
42nd time that Andre Holland has broken of a pass in his career, the most in Oregon State history. Smith with a blitz in his face, downfield she goes, and that's McCorey Collins. Did he hold on? Yes, he did.
Boy, what a great deal of patience by Akili Smith. His players are just flying and flailing their bodies around him, and he unleashes the ball. McCorey Collins, the big split end, who comes from all the way across the field to make the play, and a great catch.
108 remaining in the first half. Smith back to the air. Ho Chang, nothing. Oregon uses their first. They have two more.
It's a one touchdown throw today. He's actually climbing the career list of touchdowns. He needs actually three today to get into a tie with Chris Miller. Chris Miller on the all-time list with 42. And, of course, Danny O'Neill leads that great group of duck throwers with 62 touchdowns. And Bill Musgrave with 60 career throws.
You know, he's such an interesting story. A guy who played 3 years as a minor league outfielder. outfielder in the Pittsburgh Pirates system. And then Akili Smith says, you know, I'm not good enough, can't hit the curveball. Goes into the J.C. ranks, and Mike Bellotti said he was very average his first year in J.C., awesome his second. And he said the same thing has happened in Eugene. Go with a nickel the rest of the way.
Exactly. Good point by Paul, though. The Oregon is so adept at running crossing routes, and it's not just short crossing routes. It's down the field crossing routes, and it is raising some confusion for the defensive backs.
On second and nine, Smith to the air. Griffin is there for the touchdown.
A 41 career touchdowns now for Akili Smith as he just rifles a thin post to Damon Griffin on the backside, the split end. And Griffin and Hartley both do such a great job of keeping the defenders on their back. That time, Griffin was able to keep Ricky Walker on his hip and make the catch.
There's the kid, Damon Griffin, who just caught his seventh touchdown pass of the year. And it gives Oregon a lead of 14-10 over Oregon State. Here's the kickoff return. Greg Ainsworth is out near the 30-yard line, where he stepped down 26 seconds to go. Let's go back to the touchdown. Smith to Griffin.
And watch as, you know, Keely Smith is going to end up dropping back behind the left tackle. They get good blocks, but then what ends up happening, Damon Griffin just runs what we call a thin post, but he pushes the defender to the outside, puts him on his hip, and beats Kenny Walker into the post. Again, just a great throw by Akili Smith, but a great route run that time by Damon Griffin.
He hasn't even played a whole half yet. 117 yards and seven catches. His best was that unbelievable game he had against Washington 3 weeks ago. Nine catches for 210 yards. Here is Jonathan Smith back to the air. Jonathan's going to run, and he will be cut down about the 37-yard line. But the clock shows 21. They do have a timeout left. Will they take it? I think Jonathan wants to go. They're going to just let they'll go to halftime. And here we go. And welcome back to the Civil War, the Battle of Oregon and Oregon State. It's the number 15 team in the nation, the Oregon Ducks, with a 14-10 lead. The story, though, is minus 16 yards rushing by Oregon. Can they continue to have success in this game with that kind of running game?
Well, I think eventually you're going to have to find a way to run the ball. Akili Smith right now, there's so much riding on his shoulders. He's carrying the load. He's doing a great job for him. But Herman Ho-Ching has to be able to rush the football the second half.
Their offensive line has done a nice job protecting Akili Smith. He has been sacked three times, but the pressure on the ground game has just been enormous.
It really has, and I tell you, credit the Oregon offensive line. They did a good job of protecting Akili Smith and the two receivers, Hartley and Damon Griffin, running down the field, getting open for him for the big gains that they've had offensively.
And Griffin back 100 yards against USC earlier this year. Ainsworth watches it go out of bounds, so Oregon State's got a decision.
Chance to talk to head coach of the Oregon Ducks, Mike Bellotti, as he came out of the locker room with his team, and certainly happy with the adjustments that his front made with protecting Akili Smith. Concerned that they're not running the ball exceptionally well, but he says if we give Akili time, we'll get the things done we want offensively. On the defensive side of the ball, very disappointed that they blew two big plays, but other than that, he thinks his team's been solid and feeling confident now that they've solved the problems of protecting Akili Smith. Back to you guys.
Akili again sacked three times in the first half, but threw two touchdown passes. Now has 28 on the season. Minus 16 for Oregon.
Well, I tell you, when you have minus 16, I mean, you know, that's going to hurt you. Although total yards, I mean, they're pretty even right there. 212 for the Beavers, 194 for Oregon.
But Akili Smith came right back and hit Damon Griffin for the go-ahead touchdown with 36 seconds remaining in the first half. Here's Ken Simonton slashing.
Rely on the defensive front trying to hold that Oregon State for University of Oregon. Bob Foster, his defense, doing a good job up front there.
And they'll run it again to Simonton. He sweeps to the outside, cuts the 50, and he is mugged there by Dietrich Moore, the outside linebacker.
He has three core philosophies, Steve, with really the whole program. One is play to win. The number two facet is play for respect. Oregon State is really, truly playing for respect. I mean, if they get five wins, that's the first time since 71. And then number three, they want to elevate their self-confidence as a team and individually.
I think they have done that, particularly the second half of the season. They just don't have too many wins to show for it. Jonathan Smith will dump it off Simonton. He will be met by the linebacker, but he gets the first down.
I mean, just dramatic. And the points went up as well, but they've been making plays down the field. And that's what Jonathan Smith has brought to this offense. But, you know, I asked Mike Riley, too, does that help you for next year? You know, you don't want to look ahead, but you know what? He knows it helps him build this team and this program for the years to come.
And Simonton for about a four-yard gain. Second down, 6 yards to go. Five runs by Ken Simonton on this drive. This is number six, and this time he is met by Chris Vandeveer, the middle linebacker.
Yeah, this time Vandeveer, of course, he stepped in for the injured Peter Sermon, who was the leading tackler in the Pac-10 a year ago. Aaron Chevron there also, but Chris Vandeveer, talking to Bob Foster before the game, he's 6'2", you know, 213, undersized, not super fast, but I tell you, he is around the football and where he is supposed to be according to assignment.
Now third down. Smith fumbles the football. Oregon tries to pick it up instead of falling on it, and it's still the Beavers.
Moore, number 29, has a shot. It's just a quarterback center exchange problem. Jonathan Smith can't find the handle. Dietrich Moore tries to pick it up, and then Kenny Simonton finally falls right on top of it, retaining possession for Oregon.
That fumble resulted in a loss in the play. Michael Fletcher, who's returned two punts for touchdowns, to bring this one back, and anything inside the 10, he's got to let go. They do, and it hits at the one, goes into the end zone. It's the Ducks' first offensive possession of the second half when we come back. Wally and the Beeve pulling for Oregon State. Let's go back and take a look at the 1992 game. And it was all kinds of rain. Monsoon-like conditions led to 10 fumbles in this thriller. The only score came with 35 seconds left in the first half as quarterback Danny O'Neill would drop back to throw and hit Willie Tate. Oregon won it 7-0 in a swamp. You know, this is the last year that Oregon State would have this football field. It's been here 15 years. They'll go back to natural surface. Oregon State, obviously, an agricultural school. They've got a great program to work with the field. And there's some Beaver fans hoping that their Oregon State football team can come back from a four-point deficit. But Akili Smith, he was hot to end the half, and he throws it right on target for a first down to Tony Hartley. But Tony simply can't hold on.
Boy, Akili Smith has been so on target. Number two in the NCAA pass efficiency. Look, the ball's right on the money. Just escape Hartley's grasp. Keeley knows it's right on target. He says, oh, come down with it.
At about 7 to 9 miles an hour, Oregon 3 for 7 in converting third downs. They've got third down and 8 yards to go. Akili steps up in the pocket. Incomplete at the 32-yard line. It is 3 and out for the Ducks. And I believe that is what the Beavers defense needed. Almost blocked. From about his 23. And Tim is running about near the 35-yard line, a return of 12 on the play. Oregon has a 14-10 lead over Oregon State. UCLA already won today. Arizona plays next Friday in a game you can watch on Fox Sports Net. UCLA still has a great chance to go to the Fiesta. Wants to either go to the Holiday or the Sun Bowl. Alexander with the catch, breaks a tackle, still on his feet to the 45-yard line.
Take a look as Tim Alexander does his part getting up the field right here. Talk about Pac-10 football. I tell you, awfully good at throwing and catching the ball and guys running all over the field. Oregon State just as good as anybody on that play.
Alexander couldn't hold on. They had that screen set up on the right side.
Ellison hasn't playing well, and you know, UCLA just kind of keeps steamrolling. But I think they have a great matchup against Miami on December 5th. But we won't know anything until December 6th.
Start offense. 5 yards from the previous spot. Still second down.
Brian has not played much since. But Smith, his game has been so strong. Now he gets the blitz. They throw the screen, and right there was that Chevron. No, it was Dietrich Moore.
Well, the defensive coordinator, Bob Foster, but Oregon State tries to set up a little screen here. Dietrich Moore just comes flying through defensively, but again, Bob Foster's defense relies on that front four and allows those linebackers to run to the football.
Now on third down and 17. Oregon showing blitz. Now they drop the linebackers, and Jonathan goes for the home run. He has his man out there, and the catch is made by James Battle.
Jonathan Smith, able to get the ball out, sets his feet and unleashes a deep ball. Boy, right there, he came to Oregon State as a walk-on, not a walk-on for long. Earned a scholarship, and just because of that very reason right there, he's able to put the ball down the field where receivers can run deep and catch it.
Inside the five, they do it again from the two, and they hand it off up the middle to the fullback. They get close. 6:47 remaining in the third quarter, and Oregon State about ready to reclaim the lead. And he is in for the touchdown.
He would feel awfully good at the half talking to his team, because he knows emotionally this offense is going to produce. Right there, Ken Simonton up and over.
So Cortez will try and give his team a three-point lead. And Jose does just that, sweeping it off to the left side.
And I jump right out. As soon as I got it, that's why.
Simonton talking with his offensive teammates about how that play got open, and he was so responsible in that long touchdown drive. Now a short kick shown by Oregon State, the 102nd meeting of the Civil War.
Drive the ball deep, but I think right there a little bit of a mistake, because you give Oregon such great field position.
Here's Herman Hoching with nowhere to go, and there's Brian Jones again.
Pads low and keep those eyes wide open.
Keely Smith backing up. He'll swing that pass back to Jerry Brown. Brown's down the sideline, but comes up shy of a first down. It is third and three with the Beavers leading by three. Here comes Breckerfield. Keely Smith reads it and dives for the first down.
Tom, we're talking about the weather conditions and it being sort of a mild 7 to 9 mile an hour wind. Well, it's starting to pick up decidedly, and I raise that point because Oregon cannot run the football. Oregon State just scored a touchdown because of the long pass on third down, throwing the ball into the wind. And Keely Smith, the Oregon Ducks, are only going to have the wind for another 4 minutes and 40 seconds. So that score was huge for Oregon State.
Boy, they missed Reuben Drone, Darren Latimer, Kevin Parker. They're going with the young running back Herman Hoching most of the night. Now they've gone with Jerry Brown, the junior from Southern California, the all-time L.A. rushing leader at Taft High School with over 5,500 yards. But now Jerry Brown comes up limping. How many running backs can they lose? I mean, I thought Reuben Drone had a remarkable game, even though he fumbled three times at UCLA. And when I found out that that kid broke his leg the next day, and he was fighting his coaches to get back in the field, having it heavily taped.
Only two teams can end up in the Fiesta Bowl in Phoenix. I tell you, I think everyone wants to see Kansas State, Tennessee, UCLA. I'd like to watch all three.
And once again, Oregon State's defense is there on second down and short. And let's see how he got hurt.
They're running right up the middle, and he gets hammered by a host. Keith Hayward Johnson, number three, put his helmet in there.
We've had two scoring plays in the third quarter that have swung the leads. Here is the Jonathan Smith pass to his wide receiver, James Battle, to the 2 yard line, and then Simonton went over the middle for the touchdown. And he must take on Anoki Breckerfield. Third down, 3 yards to go. Smith whips the pass to his tight end, Jed Weaver, for a first down. Almost 18 minutes to go. Smith, he had single coverage left, now he comes back right and completes the pass at the 27-yard line. Then it's dropped by Weaver. He had it right in his numbers 8-1 and just could not hold on. Well, here we are at the Civil War meeting between Oregon and Oregon State, and it's the Beavers by three. And Jameel Braithwaite went right in Smith's face, but he gets the pass off for what is very close to a first down. Let's see where they mark his forward progress.
They move the pocket to allow Akili Smith enough time to throw. Right here, a good look at their two wideouts, Griffin and Hartley. They both just kind of run stop routes. Akili Smith with a lot of heat. Once again, Braithwaite right there along with Brian Rogers putting the heat on him, but he knows he's awfully close to a first down. They actually gave him a pretty good spot. Bunch of good throwers in that group.
And how good is Carson Palmer going to be?
Oh, he'll be good. I tell you, you know, a little baptism by fire today against the UCLA Bruins, but that game like that will pay off for him down the road.
Third down, inches to go. Akili Smith hands off. And they will get the first down just barely. But Oregon has a great history of tremendous quarterbacks. I mean, Dan Fouts played at Oregon. Chris Miller, Bill Musgrave, Bob Berry, Norm Van Brocklin. Shai Huntington was the first All-American back in 1960. You know what's interesting about Shai Huntington? He also holds the single-game interception record with four in one game in 1917. What? And it was a whale of a game. I don't know who it was against, but it was a
I was going to ask you, how does he know this? Golly, take a look at the pass efficiency ratings. Julie Smith only trailing two lanes. Undefeated. Sean King.
Smith's going for the home run. He hits Griffin. No, he can't hold on to the 10-yard line, but Smith may have been hit late as a flag came back deep in the offensive backfield.
Looking to pass on the defense. Half the distance. First down.
Well, Keely Smith does a great job once again holding on to the ball as long as possible and let those long patterns take place out there. And really the penalty is going up towards the head.
Smith back to the air. He'll dump it off to Herman Ho-Ching. He's got room. He's out of bounds at the 7-yard line. And Ho-Ching now has a right hip problem. They now have three running backs out, and two are hurt.
And it looks like he gets a hip pointer. He is playing. He has a big brace on that left knee. I saw him before the game, and he's a good-looking athlete. But right here, you see, all of a sudden.
Jerry Brown's back in the game and leans forward near the 6-yard line. Mike Riley really needs his defense to step up right here.
On the defense, half the distance, automatic first down.
USC on a 62-yard run on the option earlier this year. He will option himself, and he'll try and run it in, and Akili scores the touchdown.
Really, it's a quarterback roll. They've moved the pocket all night long. This time, just more or less fake away, and really, it's a run-pass option for Akili Smith. He uses his speed this time, races to the corner. Touchdown, Oregon again. The lead changes hands.
Civil War has always been dramatic. The point after touchdown is good, and Oregon is back in front. Akili Smith has thrown for 28 touchdowns this year. He has run for another three. He is a huge reason Oregon's going to go to a major bowl this year, but they have to beat Oregon State first. They came in with a record of 8-2. Oregon State was 4-6, and here's the kickoff return by Greg Ainsworth. And Dietrich Moore levels him at the 21-yard line. We talked with Mike Bellotti about how his quarterback, Akili Smith, has improved this year.
I couldn't have expected anything more. Akili has certainly gone beyond my expectations. He's as good a quarterback as I'd ever hoped to coach. He was always a great athlete. He's become a great quarterback. He knows the system. He understands defenses. He's a great leader. He's made strides in his personal life as well as his college football career. And he is playing as well as any quarterback in the nation.
And Mike said that he and Akili talked about people saying that he was the best athlete at quarterback. And he said, are you satisfied with just that? And Akili said, no, I want to be the best. And boy, he certainly has grown up so much this year.
Well, I tell you, you know, you really have to credit Mike Bellotti because his offensive system, they remember, I mean, they're on track to put their first 10-win season together ever in that program. Keely Smith is awfully important, but Mike Bellotti's offense and his strategies, you know, they've had three different offensive coordinators in the last 4 years, so they've had a lot of turnover, but Mike Bellotti has kept his system in place and attribute that to a lot of Keely Smith's success.
Now it's the other Smith's turn. Jonathan, second down, 5, throws it to Ainsworth. Ainsworth is out of bounds. It was Greg Ainsworth's 75-yard touchdown that gave Oregon the state the lead in the second.
Oregon, they caught Oregon in a blitz. They're just hoping Jonathan Smith has good recognition once again against this defense, able to get the ball out to his wideouts.
They're zoning him this time, and they'll run the football, and knifing forward is Jason Dandridge, but just a short gain up near the 39-yard line. That will be the final play of the third quarter.
Mike Bellotti, the coach of Oregon, has a saying. He goes, the games to remember are won in November, and he's 10-1 in November. He's got to continue that to get to a major bowl game.
Well, so true. Those games played in late in the season, especially in November, are the ones that are going to determine, one, where you rank, number two, which bowls you go to, and a lot of times it's going to clarify the conference race as well.
Well, they'll run the football. This is Jason Dandridge. He is through and very close to a first down, then fumbles the football, but I believe the Beavers will get it.
Well, watch as Jason Dandridge brings it up the field. McLemore, the free safety, number nine, comes over. He's also hit by Dietrich Moore, and the ball, sure enough, does come out. Dietrich Moore, number 29, really...
Jonathan Smith met call a timeout here. They were still scrambling in their huddle. The clock was winding down to 4 seconds, and Smith had to take time. It is the first. Nothing new at the Civil War in Corvallis. A four-point lead for Oregon. But five of the last eight games have been decided by 7 points or less. And Jonathan Smith will play action pass, go deep, and they throw it away. He was trying to hit Joe Kuykendall on a surprise play with a linebacker covering the tight end. And he handles this one. He's got the wind to his back, and he just sends it through the end zone. Oregon will start from their own 20-yard line with a four-point lead, 21-17. Thank you, Kevin. As Oregon trying to win a big game and get to either the Holiday or the Sun Bowl, Jerry Brown sweeps around the left side. Lead by four.
Boy, I tell you, they can't. And that's amazing, because usually when you have a lead in a big game, you've had some success rushing the football. But the Oregon State defense has just played great against the run. And Oregon, quite frankly, able to ride the arm in the success of Akili Smith.
Herman Hoching, who hurt his hip earlier, now is back in the game as running back, taking over for Jerry Brown. Akili Smith looking. Now he'll scramble, and he will be gone.
Right here, Akili Smith commits to one side. He committed to the left side, the split inside, a one-person route. Receiver was covered up. He had nowhere to go with the ball. You can't come all the way across the field.
The field has two. Ball just picked up his first. Jerry Brown back in the game. Herman Hoching couldn't go with that right hip. Smith has to scramble. Now he'll run. Gets a block, and does he get the first down? Yes, he does.
Once again, he's able to move around in the pocket. He knows, all of a sudden, he gets flushed. Watch the pump fake right there. It gets Brian Jones up in the air, and then he's able to tiptoe down the sidelines after he drops his shoulder.
And they'll run it to Jerry Brown. Not much. And again, they just can't get that running game going.
Being his hip specifically, it's in the lower back, and he's got a huge bruise on his right side low back. He came over, they added an additional pad to protect that area. He rode the exercise bike. He actually told me, I'm ready to go back in, but certainly will there, but not the way right now. He had to go back out of the game, but we'll keep you updated.
So Paul sent him back into the game. He plays one play, and that ball almost intercepted. Armin Hatcher. Third and 10. The rush is on. The pass is caught by Haynes. First down to the 44-yard line.
Boy, Oregon State puts a ton of pressure on Akili Smith from the pocket. Watch as he stands in. He gets drilled. They come low, but the catch by Donald Haynes. Remarkable. Watches Anoki Brechterfield right there, number 56, just steamrolls his man. I believe he got pushed into Akili Smith. But the ball once again on target.
The Ducks believe. Brown is wrapped up. He'll lose 3 or 4 yards.
Jameel Braithwaite's done a great job this year. Fourth in the Pac-10 and tackles for loss. He makes plays behind the line of scrimmage. Another one of that great senior class at Oregon State.
But they have a four-point lead, and they're driving with the football. And here goes Smith back to the air, hitting his favorite target, Damon Griffin. That will set up a third and about 7-8 situation.
Well, Anoki Brechterfield once again playing as hard as any player in the Pac-10. And time he rolls up into the legs of Akili Smith. I know if you're a quarterback, you don't really like
defensive end who has to come this time on third and six. And here he comes. And they may have held him. They sacked the football. Brechterfield is there, but can't come up with it.
Flag on the play as well. But the player, Oregon State defensive end, Brechterfield's getting held. Brian Jones, number 43, strips the ball, but the vital mistake, Brechterfield tries to pick it up, and he doesn't get it.
Offside, defense, 5 yards from the previous spot, still third down.
Offside's Oregon State. See right there, the guilty individual. Get it for you.
He scored a touchdown in that situation earlier. Nope, they'll run Brown, and Brown is stumped.
He does a good job, but he just doesn't get the execution at the line of scrimmage. And again, credit Oregon State. Jonathan Jackson, the number two tackler in the Pac-10, and Brian Rogers there to just put the hammer on Jerry Brown.
Double tight end and a wing to the left side. Akili will throw. He will dump it off. The catch is made for the first down.
Boy, Greg Payne, a nice job out of the backfield. Hasn't taken a lot of snaps tonight.
Ducks roll.
Behind
Ducks
the, roll. At the fullback down. Position. And they're right there, a little play action.
And he has picked a different party on each trip down the floor. Brown, big hole, but he's hit. Knocked down by Jonathan Jackson, the middle linebacker.
He's just done such a great job on this drive controlling the clock.
They may need to force a turnover. Smith is going downfield for his tight end, Weaver. It is almost picked off by Ricky Walker.
They've had good tight ends in the past. Jed Weaver, just another one of those big players that can run. But Ricky Walker that time with great position.
Stay in this game with 8-11 to go. Smith in trouble. He circles around and he'll just throw it away. A flag will... does not go down. There was Weaver in the vicinity, but that was clearly Smith trying to just get the Oregon Ducks have opened up a 24-17 lead over Oregon State. Oregon trying for 10 wins in a season for the first time in the history of the school. Five times they've won nine games, but they never have been able to get that number 10. They need to beat Oregon State to stay eligible for that. And Ainsworth gets the football out past the 28-yard line.
Pilati in the kickoff team of Oregon done a nice job kicking away from Tim Alexander, who 2 weeks ago versus UCLA, 266 all-purpose yards and a couple huge kickoff returns.
Well, Jonathan Smith needs a big ending. And he almost throws a big ending to Dietrich Moore, which would have finished this game.
And remember, Moore had a big interception return for a touchdown a week ago versus ASU. But watch, he just breaks on the ball. Bad hand position by the linebacker.
Now he wants to beat the Beavers. Smith goes over the middle and completes the pass to his tight end, Joe Kuykendall. Are they going to bring the corner? No, he's dropping back. They'll go zone. Smith looking that side. And, boy, he threw that pass right in the back of his offensive lineman.
Again, Oregon rushing four, able to collapse the pocket. Put a lot of heat on Jonathan Smith. Ball falls incomplete.
Fessler, line drive kick. Belcher's got a chance for return. It hits his leg. And Oregon State will recover.
Because Michael Fletcher is so aggressive as a punt returner. He's one of the best in the Pac-10, one of the best in the nation. He'll catch them all, but right there, not decisive enough to get out of the way. Darnell Robinson, a backup linebacker, there to recover. But once it touches you, it's a live ball. Robinson right there to fall on top of it. Oregon State with great field position.
Need a touchdown to tie. Will they go for it right here? Well, Smith will hand the football off. Simonton is through. Kenz to the 20. Still on his feet to the 18-yard line.
Once again, Kenny Simonton out of Pittsburgh High School in Pittsburgh, California. There, lower the shoulder and then spin. Just get away. Run through some arm tackles. And just remember, he needed 129 coming in tonight to reach 1,000 on the season.
Bauer goes in motion. They run Simonton again. And Simonton dives to the 13.
State's offensive line getting a pretty good push.
He'll keep it on the ground. Simon to the 10. He's got the first down to the 5-yard line.
You know, and a turnover will always always just reverse the momentum. Oregon looked as though they had the ball in the lead there, and Dietrich Moore, of course, dropped an interception, which looked to be a sure touchdown.
He will hand it off to Ken Simon, 10 for the touchdown.
Boy, there is absolutely no quitting in this team, and credit Mike Riley for having fun playing football. He keeps those guys with a lot of spirit in them, and right here, just great blocking up front, not great tackling. Cortez just drives this one through the uprights.
Cortez hooks it, but hooks it through.
I love you, mama. I love you, mama.
Ken Simonton telling mom he loves her back in Pittsburgh. A great return man. He's returned two punts for touchdowns. He made a mistake on the last return. It hit his leg and gave Oregon State the football. They have tied the game. Now Cortez, with the wind to his back, just hammers it out of the end zone. But trying for win number 9 tonight. Smith downfield looking for Hartley. He makes the catch. Oh, what a play.
Boy, oh boy. Tony Hartley comes in averaging over 21 yards a catch. Has one TD on the night tonight, but Akili Smith just launches it over the safety's head. Again, Oregon State looks like they're playing four across, so it's man on man, he and Andre Holland, and Hartley just able to run right by him. Right down the middle of the field, 101 career catches, 18 of those for scores, 9 of those this year.
Akili Smith. Run the football. Jerry Brown is a big hole, and he's got the first down.
Exactly what the longest run of the night versus that hard-hitting defense did. And well, you see Jerry Brown just kind of skips through the hole and then lowers his pads, and he's able to knock off 12 for the first down. But once again, I tell you, Akili Smith right now, he's going to take a little time on off the clock as they get closer into scoring territory.
They'll run it again to Brown. Oregon State's defense does a nice job stretching it out, but Brown's speed just too much as he gains about 3, 4, 5 yards in the play. Second down. Oregon needs 2. They'll run their fullback, and it is just a short game. There is Nathan, who made his first 14 this year before missing 2 in all that rain against Washington 2 weeks ago. Brown, not much there, and he's wrapped up. 3-yard loss in the play. It'll be 2nd and 13. Jerry Brown is being helped off the field. They don't have any backs left, do they?
No, I tell you what.
They've lost 5 this year.
I don't know if anyone else is left in the cupboard. But once again, Akili Smith, one of the top quarterbacks in the nation, over center, really falls back on him now that the running back's out of the game.
Herman Hoching, playing with that bad back, is in the game. And they'll give it to Herman, and he is wrapped up. Look at this. They're going backwards.
Boy, and again, they just play that gap cancellation defense. They're responsible for a gap. Hard-hitting, well-coached. And they make the play.
And we'll take a timeout. 2 minutes, 41 seconds left. Mike Bellotti. His team is tied at 24. And he will throw. And he's looking for the home run. Tony Hartley. What a catch! Touchdown!
Wow, I tell you what, one of the best quarterbacks in the nation right there. Akili Smith hangs in the pocket, and once again, looks like Oregon State is victimized right at the end of the game. I mean, they got two guys, they got double coverage down there. Andre Holland, the corner, didn't make the play versus UCLA 2 weeks ago. He doesn't make it tonight. Oregon with the home run and the touchdown. Keeley Smith, of course, ties Chris Miller with 42 career touchdown throws for the Ducks. But look at Hartley just go up, just snatch the ball away. I mean, he just goes up and not to be denied. Again, one of those deep crossing routes that have troubled Oregon State all night long. Big play once again. Tony Hartley having a big night, comes down with the ball, touchdown.
Long kick. It'll be Alex. Alexander who cuts in front of Ainsworth. And Tim up the middle will muscle his way to the 28-yard line, but is stuffed there. Hey, let's go back to the 94 game of the Civil War. It was Oregon trailing 13-10. And Danny O'Neill of Oregon drove the Ducks to victory with just great passing down the stretch, like this 19-yard pass to Dino Filio to come from behind. And Oregon would win the game 17-13. Danny O'Neill, one of the great players in the Pac-10 Conference that year, he led his team into the Rose Bowl. They would lose to Penn State. Five games in the 90s have been decided by seven or fewer points in this great Civil War. Jonathan Smith downfield, first down. Battle to the 48-yard line.
Jonathan Smith having a lot of different options to throw the ball, but credit again that Mike Riley offense. There's a lot of options, and they're getting people down the field and releasing five into the route.
He completes the pass again to Greg Ainsworth.
Feeling here, I want to see Jonathan Smith lead his team to a touchdown because I want to see if Akili Smith can do it.
Boy, I tell you, the Civil War is as good as a rivalry as it gets, and there's a lot that happened in the nation, especially today.
Smith dumps it off, has his man to the 30-yard line. He'll still need one more for a first down, so it is second and one.
So the clock keeps running, minute 40 left.
Well, they've got zone coverage, and they throw underneath. They get the first down. This is Tim Alexander breaking a tackle. Alexander is gone!
I'll tell you, this is an awfully important extra point. Just remember, they got to get it settled, but Jonathan Smith just gets rid of the ball. Right now, Tim Alexander, just a quick little hitch. He's able to knife through defenders, shake a couple arm tackles, and race into the end zone. Touchdown, Beavers.
There's the extra point. It is good.
Again, Mike Pilotti, he knows he's in a dogfight when he comes up here to Corvallis. Again, just a hitch right there. Tim Alexander, how appropriate. One of the senior leaders of this team, and he's played offensive and played quarterback. He's run the wishbone. He's been in this offense for a long time, and Jonathan Smith delivering the ball once again.
He does to Fletcher at the 3-yard line. Michael is down at the 21. Both teams have great specialists. Nathan Villegas for Oregon, Jose Cortez for Oregon State. Smith goes sideline to Donald Haynes, and Haynes stays in bounds.
Oh, yeah, if you're Donald Haynes, go ahead. You're right on the sideline. Step out of bounds.
We must remind our fans that Tom Ramsey is a former quarterback playing in the sunshine of L.A. Here is Smith in trouble. He will complete the pass at midfield. I thought he had no one open. Oregon State showing zone defense. Akili Smith rifling it downfield past Damon Griffin.
You can tell he's an ex-baseball player. That ball, he just rifles it. Comes out real hard. I tell you, that's a tight ball for a rainy.
Second and 10, 53 seconds to go. Flag goes down. The pass is thrown underneath to Hartley. Gets the 41-yard line, but somebody may have helped.
Holding offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Still second down.
Oregon State has lost two games this month by 1 point. Another to UCLA in a play with 30 seconds left in the game. Mike Bellotti, he doesn't care. He wants win number 9 and win number 10 in the bowl game. The closest that Oregon has ever come to 10 wins in a season was seasons 1928, 33, 48, 94, and 95. But they fell all 5 times. Smith will be sacked. 32-yard line by Braithwaite.
And Oregon takes one. I'm not sure if that's a great call that time by Oregon taking the sack here. Sometimes you might just say, hey, you know what? We've lost all this yardage.
Well, here's the scoring in the second half. Simonton went in for Oregon State for the lead. Then Akili Smith ran in on an option play and gave Oregon the lead. Simonton for 5 yards. Akili Smith came right back in this period to Tony Hartley with a minute or 2.5 to play. And then this great pitch pass to Tim Alexander for the tying touchdown. What a great game. 34 seconds left. And Oregon runs the football. They're going to try and let it run out, but Oregon State says, we will not have that. We'll take a timeout here, make you punt it to us. Maybe that's what Mike is thinking. We're going to go for the return, and if we don't get the return or the block punt, we'll go into overtime.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, how big a game is this, though? You know, both head coaches have said this is a, you know, it's not like other rivalries because this, the whole state of Oregon isn't that big population-wise, but there's a lot of recruits here tonight. You know, they kind of weigh the decisions, you know. I don't want to be a Duck, I want to be a Beaver. But Mike Riley, I tell you what, both head coaches do a great job with their programs, and no better game than right now, right in front of us.
Gets rid of it. He gives Alexander a chance. Tim lets it go. And he says, nobody touch it. They will go to overtime. The first time the Civil War has ever gone to overtime. They've been playing since the late 1800s. The longest rivalry west of the Rocky Mountains. First team leading after a completed round will win the football game. Here comes Alexander and Brian Rogers to meet the four captains of Oregon.
And the winner gets Gordon Reese explaining it.
For which end of the field we're going to play on.
Both teams.
Right. No deferring. What do you want? Heads.
He calls a head.
He wants another head.
He calls another head. Head.
You want defense.
Okay.
So now, you're on offense.
I want the ball down here.
You want the ball down at that end. Okay?
So we're going to list.
We will come back with our overtime period to the Civil War. Pac-10 football on Fox Sports Net. We are tied at 31 and going to overtime. Jonathan Smith, the quarterback. He'll hand off first play. Look at this. It is down to the 8-yard line. Ken Simonton has got over 1,000 yards rushing.
Boy, I tell you, once again, the offensive line doing a great job opening the hole for Kenny Simonton, who just burst right through it. McLemore finally able to drag him down.
Only four Beavers have ever gone over 1,000 yards in a season. Ken is one of them, the only freshman ever to go over 1,000 yards. They'll give it to him again. He slides forward. He is to the 4-yard line and then tackled by Brandon McLemore. Here's second and goal in overtime. Simonton again smashing to about the 1.5-yard line.
Looking for their fifth win, and they haven't had five wins since 1971. So you tell me, they've gone through some long droughts. The Beavers,
third down, goal to goal, from just outside the one. Smith hands off Simonton, and the Beavers take the lead.
Right here, Oregon having to come back now and get a touchdown of their own right, but Ken Simonton just dances in the end zone. Riley very happy, and I tell you, he's lost some close ones, but this one, right now, they put the pressure right back on the Ducks.
Oregon State, meantime, has only one overtime game. This is the second in their history.
Yeah, the Civil War, of course, never having been an OT before. And
Smith runs play action, whips it to the right, and his man is just belted. They blitz. Smith throws it to Damon Griffin. Nothing there. And Griffin is smothered at the 30. They'll lose five.
What you don't want to do is celebrate too soon. But Terrence Carroll came up from his free safety position and just rocked Damon Griffin. Keely Smith barely gets the ball off, too. Jamil Braithwaite puts a lot of heat on. But watch as Carroll just comes up. Pow!
Oregon State rushes four. Smith steps up. Downfield she goes. It is incomplete. Fourth and 10. This pass, this play is for the game. Oregon State has not won five games in a season since 1971.
Keely Smith, third down play. That last play just fires it right down the middle. Terrence Carroll with the tip. Comes down to this fourth down crucial play.
Griffin to the left. Haynes Hartley to the right. Smith. Hartley does not hold on. And Oregon State wins. There is a flag down to the field, though. And the officials are saying everyone off.
Well, this is going to be interesting because a flag dropped late and a flag. A game cannot end on a defensive penalty. Well, this is going to be interesting. I don't know how you're going to remove 35,000 people from the field, but
that could be a first down.
Well, it is going to be a first down. Sure enough, some of the coaches realize it. I know the Oregon Ducks have realized it, but Oregon State not realizing it. Mike Bellotti, he's been around in some of these situations before, and it's going to take a moment or two before they clear the field.
It was a rather late flag because the play had already happened, and there were several fans already coming out of the field. And there's Gordon Reese.
Well, they're starting to climb up onto the goalposts.
There is a penalty on the play. Pass interference, defense.
Mike Riley wait.
I tell you, you hate to see flags come out anytime, but especially on a late fourth down. When I say late, Andre Holland, I believe, again, the much maligned corner.
Did you think it was pass interference?
You know, I didn't think so. I thought it was more or less an incidental collision. One more look at it as he comes in.
Oh, he did get the right.
I tell you what, that's an awfully close call. The referee, I'm gonna let him. If he throws the flag, sure enough, it's gonna be interference. It's an awfully close play. Donald Haynes was the receiver he's trying to get the ball to. So this will be a first down for Oregon. They're going to have to continually clear the field and get about 50 people off the goalpost. That may be more difficult.
Jonathan Smith, the quarterback for Oregon State, was leading them. Please get off the field. There's Mike Bellotti, who still feels he's got a chance, and a great one now with a first and goal inside the 10-yard line, or right at the 10-yard line.
Remember, if Oregon, they'll have a first down here, and what'll end up happening, they'll have four downs to get into the end zone. If they get into the end zone, Oregon State has to come back out, start another series themselves.
On the defense, it's 15 yards from the previous spot, and it's an automatic first down.
But the officials threw the flag so late that's why the fans came rushing onto the field.
Well, what had happened, the referee threw the flag. He just didn't get it out of his pocket. It did come out. But I saw him go back and pick it up and then toss it to right where the play had happened. So just a collision right there. And
you know, the way this game has gone, back and forth. If Oregon comes back and wins this game, we may have a civil war in Oregon.
Oregon, you know, it's funny, no one moved up their sideline. They saw the flag come out, and they knew they were going to have another shot.
Smith backing up, fires it over the middle. Jed Weaver has it to the one-yard line. It will be first and goal.
Check the heart medication. Tell you, once again, Akili Smith able to fire the ball. They still got to put a little heat on Akili Smith if they want to stop the Ducks.
Jerry Brown, he is stopped. I do not believe he got in. No, he is stopped about a half-yard shot.
I mean, it is a fierce battle right now. They're emptying everything they have.
Brown, he is stopped. Two-yard shot. Terrence Carroll.
And now with Carroll coming off the edge and just putting a helmet right into the side of number 21, Jerry Brown. All of a sudden, they're back a couple yards. Mike Bellotti trying to definitely play action, get a little runner pass.
And he will play action. He's in trouble. He loops an end zone. Weaver for the touchdown. but they still have to go for the extra point.
And Oregon State
game up.
Taking a timeout, but right there, Akili Smith once again, a little play action into the
Oregon
line.
Oregon State taking the timeout. Well, they're making Nathan wait and wait and wait. And what has been a brilliantly played football game here in Corvallis. They have not won at Corvallis since 1988, 10 years ago. They beat the Ducks 21-10. He got it. And we are going to the second overtime in Corvallis. He was on the sideline the last time Oregon State had a winning season in 1970. The most played rivalries in the history of college football, Minnesota and Wisconsin have met 108 times. Kansas and Mizzou, 107 times. Texas and Texas A&M, but right there is Oregon and Oregon State.
See if you can't hold your opponent to zero.
Akili Smith back, fires the football, completes it at the 17-yard line. All of a sudden, he's going away from his wide receiver. That was on fourth down.
Oh, and it's interesting. Sure enough, he does get jarred before the ball actually hits him, and the side judge is the one that throws the flag, but as I said, the flag came out of his pocket, just dropped on the ground right near the sideline, and nobody could see that the flag had been thrown.
Fans poured onto the field, and he picked it up and threw the flag. Akili Smith will be set.
Micah Moore coming from the outside linebacker spot. Unblocked, just puts his helmet right into the back of Akili Smith. And
Smith throws and completes it for a first down to again his tight end, Jed Weaver. They run Brown, nope, and a flag goes down. This could be holding.
As you mentioned, the start of each overtime, we reflip, and Oregon State deferred. Oregon gets to choose the goal that they want to attack. And if you're wondering why they went this way, because really after that torrential rainstorm that has ended, the wind not a factor. But there are about 15,000 Oregon fans down at this end, a much more friendly area of the football stadium.
They bring more in the blitz. Smith throws, completes the pass. Another flag goes down.
Offense, 10 yards, while the foul, still first down.
You know, when the flags come out.
69, looks like he's holding.
Yeah, Aguirre.
That was Marco Aguirre. Smith, look for that tight end. Terrence Carroll came right through him. Another flag goes down. This will be pass interference.
Jars the
pass interference on the defense.
Taken over.
Ball be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
I was going to say a moment ago, if you have first and 43, I'll tell you, you know who I want as my quarterback? Akili Smith.
Because Oregon has had no running game. They throw it underneath. Weaver is there. Weaver breaks the tackle. Chet has the first down to the 26-yard line. Well, that old cliche of take what the defense gives you, and right now they are giving them the tight end.
Yep, and Akili Smith knows it right off the bat. And Ketchman blitz once again, and he just pops the ball into tight end Jed Weaver. And the man that came up to make the hit, Terrence Carroll, he's down right now.
And Aaron Wright must come in to take over.
Look at the total number, 445.
He's a leading rusher, too.
Yeah.
From the 26-yard line. They'll swing that pass out to the running back, and there's nothing there.
Again, Oregon State defense reading the play. They're able to execute, dig through the blockers, and put the hit on KP, Kevin Parker.
Nine. Will they throw to the tight end? Weaver looks to get open. They throw wide to Hartley, and Hartley has a short gain to the 23-yard line, so it's third down. 18 for 20. Oregon has been better than 50% converting third downs. And this is a third and six. Smith whips it right to Weaver, and Weaver leans forward and gets the first down.
Pass coverage on those wideouts, and it allows Jed Weaver to kind of be the unfound man. And then all of a sudden he sneaks out, pops out right along the sideline, gets enough for the first down.
He's been a splendid tight end, the main target of Akili Smith in the late goings of the football game, and now in overtime. Over the middle they go. It's Weaver again trying to break a tackle, but he'll have a short gain.
Weaver with 10 catches, actually 11 catches for Jed Weaver tonight.
37 on the season. Hard Hartley, Griffin both go left. Haynes is to the right. And Weaver is a tight end to the right side. And Achille is looking his way. Now he'll have to scramble. And he is sat down at the 10-yard line.
John Ball, another part of that Hawaiian connection.
Wow.
To that defensive line of the Beavers. John Ball out of Punahou High.
Third and six. That's winding down, and now Oregon has to take a timeout. Smith down the middle. It is broken up. Fourth down and six. A great play by Micah Moore.
Oregon going to elect to kick the 3 points here, but Akili Smith does a great job holding the ball high. Great fundamentals. Fires the ball low, just a shade behind Tony Hartley. Micah Moore locked on to a wideout that time, making the play.
This from 26. It is good. Jose Cortez for Oregon State, and Villegas we just saw for the University of Oregon. Kevin, for the first play of Oregon State's overtime drive, the second overtime here in Corvallis. Jonathan Smith in trouble. He throws it to Maurer, the tight end, and Maurer has about an 8-9 yard gain. They'll need two for a first. Let's see if they run Simonton this time. Yes, they will, and Simonton has the first down. Simonton to the five. Touchdown. Oregon State does win.
Well, they're getting better at the celebration. Now they're all over the field. Second time around.
So that's it from Corvallis, Oregon, in a fabulous football game where Oregon State beats Oregon 44-41 in two overtimes.